you hate it when you are browsing all the texture sites and you still can't find the right texture for your project? Have you ever thought that this texture could be right across the street? But how can you make a texture for your projects? Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. In today's video, I'll show you how to create realistic PBR materials with your own textures. You just need a camera, or a smartphone, and a cloudy day. By the way, if you stay with me until the end of the video, I'll let you know how you can get my PBR textures for free. The very first thing you need to do to start shooting your own textures is to go out on a cloudy day. Because if you don't do this, then you'll have all the very harsh shadows from the sun on your textures and they'll not look good to use in 3D software. Even if you don't have a fully cloudy day, which was my case when I was taking these textures, you can always find a place with a shadow and you can just shoot that area so you don't have any harsh light from the sun. Avoid wide angle lenses. The best you can use for the textures is above 50mm. Fixed lens for these are great. Try to shoot as flat as possible so you don't have any weird distortions on your photos. Now I have my texture that I took here in Photoshop and I'm just going to slightly adjust here in the camera raw. Maybe like this. Highlights as well. They are too blown out here, so remove the highlights and increase the shadows as well. Because if I leave it like this, to be in the texture, all of this, and I don't want this. I want this to be within the software to be creating. So I'm just going to increase so we get some of these details back. Let's see, can increase this. Okay, now let's go to here, lens correction. Let's click remove a chromatic aberration and we have this enable profile corrections as well. It already detected automatically my lens, but I still want to remove here the distortion to zero. And it removed automatically the vignetting. So if I click before and after, you see that it removed the vignetting. And this is important so we have the same tone throughout all the texture. So I'm going to open. And now I'm going to make this texture square. And let's see, I think this part is good. Just going to crop it. And I'm going to remove, since I want this texture to be tileable, I will remove this part because I think it will be too noticeable in the repetition. So just grab the lasso tool and just drag around like this. Now press Shift F5 and press OK. So Photoshop does its magic, remove that part, and also going to remove this part here. Okay, and maybe this, and that's it. Okay, now let's save this. You can save it as PNG, and I'm gonna name it Bark. Okay. Now, head over to boundingboxsoftware.com and here you'll find a software called Materialize. It's a free-to-use software to make all of these maps, the normal, the displacement, gloss map, and just on the bottom click download. And then you'll have this software. And here you have to start by uploading the diffuse map. Basically the texture that we created. And we're gonna create this icon here, this O icon. And let's start bark, and okay. So here we have the texture. Now the first thing we need to do, we need to create a height map. Height map is the same as displacement map. So create, I'm gonna press here on displace and here the default one. So we can choose, for example, cracks, funky, or here details. These details, if you have contrast, so basically like this, all of these parts here will be going up. So you don't want this, you want all the these parts to be dark. So basically like this. So all of this goes down and the light areas goes up. But this is too much. I can show you how it would look if you leave it like this. So see, even became super slow. It's not accurate at all. So let's go back, click create again. And let's just leave it as this place. And here default. Okay, now I have to adjust this again. Leave it about here. Let's see how it looks now. Oh, actually, just leave it like this. Okay, I still think it looks too strong, even though I can just reduce here the displacement. Well, actually, it's not bad at all. Just a little bit. Yeah, you see how we have now all of this geometry going out. So it's creating this illusion. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. Just go here back. You can always increase a little bit the contrast. So the more contrast you increase, all of this will be higher and this will be lower. Don't want too much, so more or less like this, it's fine. You can increase as well here, these fine details. Okay. I'm gonna leave it like it is. Set as height map. Okay. By the way, you have this height reveal slider. If you move it, okay, so you can see the before and your changes that you are making. So set as height map. Now we need to create a normal map. So create. And you have some presets, default, smooth, crisp, and mids. I'm gonna leave it at mids and just click set as normal map. You can check the difference now. And it's looking pretty good so far. Okay. Now we need to add a smoothness map. And smoothness map is the same as gloss map. So just press create. And actually, I think it's already looking good. I'm just going to increase a little bit the contrast. This bias will make it lighter. So about here, increase the contrast. Let's leave it as these settings. And let's create an ambient occlusion map as well. It's too much, this part. AO power, reduce a little bit. Let's see. Let's leave it as it is, set as AO map. Now let's preview. I think it's looking pretty good. Okay, now we need to add as well some tiling. So when we start to repeat the texture horizontally or vertically, you will not notice all the sharp edges. So for example, let's put here. Actually, this texture is already quite good. You almost don't see anything with this displacement. But if I remove the displacement, okay, now you can see here the sharp line. Okay, now let's go to tile maps. And let's put this texture tiling as 2. And we can see this here, these sharp lines, right? So we can adjust the X overlap. So if you look here, on this area, if you increase the X overlap, so leave it about here, and then we have the edge fall off. So if you increase the edge fall off, see, it will start to merge, so you don't have any more of this sharp line. And the Y as well, let's see, start like this, go higher. I think like this is okay, you don't see the line anymore. Let's put it back to 1. Okay, and then you have to click set maps. First, you need to go here and set the resolution. okay? 4K is nice. And set maps. So it updates our maps now. We can go back to the material and let's preview. So if you increase all the way the displacement, but let's leave it at about 1 almost. Now let's save the maps. And to do this, we'll select PNG and save project. And here we'll create a new folder. I'm going to call it export, confirm, and bark select. Now we need to import the normal map and the gloss map into Photoshop. So in order to use this in Lumion, we need to put the gloss map on the alpha channel of the normal map. Okay, now we will save it as Targa and with 32-bit. Okay. By the way, if you want to know more about how to create realistic PBR materials with Lumion, I have another video for that, and I'll leave a link in the top right corner. Now let's go to Lumion and let's select this and select standard and let's select our maps. So the diffuse. We need to remove this colorization and let's increase the map scale about, let's see, about here, it's fine. Now let's select the correct normal map as well. And the displacement. Okay, now with the displacement, we can increase the slider. Okay. You can see now the details of the displacement. You can always still adjust a little bit these values. Let's go to the render and see how this looks. And so I think this looks pretty nice. You can see all of these details. You can even increase a little bit the detailing with going to the weathering of the material, for example, weathering, and just increase a little bit wood, for example, maybe like so. And there it is. This is how easy it is to create a PBR material from a photo to use in your projects. If you want to know more in detail how to create realistic PBR materials with Lumion, I have a course in which I teach how to create high quality and realistic renders in Lumion and with the shortest render time. I'll leave a link to it in the description below this video. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching. I'll leave a link to get my free PBR textures in the description below this video. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumb up, subscribe, and click the bell button to get notified when I publish new videos. See you in the next ones.